Dear students, we have already finished our first chapter, that is chemical reactions and equations. I hope you must have understood everything and you have done the assignments given by me. Today we will start our second chapter, that is acid, base and salts. It is our second chapter, so let's get ready to study this chapter. Now I just want to discuss that in our junior classes in 9th and 8th, we have studied that acid and base occurs. Acid is something we in normal life we see it has a sour taste, or base has a bitter taste. In naturally occurring things, we have seen lemon, orange and other fruits which has sour taste. सॉर टेस्ट मीन्स खट्टा. जो हम खट्टा टेस्ट करते हैं नींबू में, लेमन में, उसमें हमको मिलता है कि वो एक खट्टापन क्यों आया. वाई दैट सॉर टेस्ट इज देयर? बिकॉज ऑफ प्रेजेंस ऑफ एसिड. नाउ हाउ वी विल नो दैट समथिंग इज एसिड और समथिंग इज बेस? We cannot say that in general we cannot say this is base or this is acid. For that we should have some observation. So how we can observe it? By the use of indicators. What are indicators? Indicators are something. Indicators are something that shows the presence of acid or base by change in color. Means indicator will change the color in presence of acid or base. Like one of the indicator is litmus paper. If acid is present, then blue litmus paper will convert into red litmus paper. Or if base is present, then red litmus will convert into blue. So this is the indicator that shows whether something is acid or something is base. Now we have understood acid and base. Indicators are natural also and indicators are sometimes synthetic also. Like in normal life you have seen turmeric, haldi. हम जब खाना बना रहे होते हैं और थोड़ा सा हल्दी का छींटा आपके कपड़े पे लग जाए, then what happens? We see that there is some change in color. When we wash that turmeric और हल्दी लगा वाला स्टेन, जब हम कपड़े को धोते हैं तो उस समय रेड कलर का कन्वर्जन हो जाता है. येलो कलर का जो करी का दाग है वो रेड कलर में कन्वर्ट हो जाता है, और जैसे ही उसमें सोप लगता है. क्यों? क्योंकि उसमें बेस आ जाता है, सोप का बेस. जब उसी कपड़े को हम धोने के बाद, वॉश करने के बाद सुखाते हैं, देन वो अगेन इट कन्वर्ट्स इनटू येलो कलर. Why it is happening? Because haldi is a natural indicator which indicates the presence of base when it is washed with the soap. So indicators बहुत सारे type के होते हैं, जैसे methyl indicator, methyl orange indicator, phenolphthalein indicator. ये हमारा दूसरा part है, but main part ये है कि acid और base क्या होते हैं. एंड एसिड और बेस जो है किसको किस में कन्वर्ट करते हैं? एसिड कन्वर्ट्स ब्लू लिटमस इनटू रेड. नॉर्मली एसिड आर सॉल्ट इन टेस्ट, बेस आर बिटर इन टेस्ट. दे कन्वर्ट रेड लिटमस टू ब्लू. नाउ इन टर्म्स ऑफ केमिकल्स और इन टर्म्स ऑफ एक्चुअली व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इनसाइड एसिड, वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड एसिड लाइक दिस. Acid is a something that gives H plus ions when it is dissolved in water. Acid is something that gives H plus ion or donate H plus ions when it comes in contact with water. It gives H3O plus, means it donate H plus ions. Only positive charge, that is H plus, not any other charge, only H plus positive charge or the ions in aqueous medium. Now, why it is happening? It is happening because H plus is unstable. For example, we take one acid, HCl. HCl will donate H plus to water. So it will make H3O ion. Why it is happening? That we can understand here. H plus is highly unstable, and we know that when water acid dissolves in water, what happens? It will release H plus ion. So what will happen to the H plus ion? It will make hydronium ion, means this H plus will react with H2O and give hydronium ion in water. It will give hydronium ion in water. So acid, when comes in contact with water, it releases H plus ions. We are not talking about any other ion. Only H plus ion is released in H2O, and it converts water into hydronium ion. That is, it converts into H3O plus. This ion is known as hydronium ion. Why it is happening? Because H plus is highly unstable. Now, there are different types of acid. Acids are organic and mineral. Now, what are organic acids? Organic acids are those organic acids which occur naturally, or they are present in the biological form, or they are derived from the biomass, or they are present naturally, like in plant tissue, tartaric acid that is present in tamarind, lactic acid that is present in milk. There are some more acids like acetic acid. Acetic acid derived from vinegar. Formic acid is also present. What is formic acid? Formic acid is present in ant sting. जब हमको चींटी काटती है तो जलता है ना, छोटा सा ऐसा लगता है, अरे जल गया, अरे लग गया. वो इसलिए लगता है क्योंकि उसमें एंट जब स्टिंग करता है, जब चींटी हमें काटती है तो उसके स्टिंग में जो निकलता है सॉल्यूशन, जिस वजह से हमें जलता है, वो इसलिए जलता है क्योंकि उसमें फॉर्मिक एसिड होता है. सो साइट्रिक एसिड, जैसे ऑरेंज जो होता है हमारा, उसमें साइट्रिक एसिड होता है. तो दीज आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक एसिड. दे आर नेचुरली डिराइव्ड और प्रेजेंट इन नेचुरल फॉर्म. दे आर डिराइव फ्रॉम plants, animals or something. These are all called as organic acid. Normally all organic acid, mostly all organic acids are weak in nature. We will discuss it later. Now, mineral acids. Mineral acids are those acids which are derived from earth. Means minerals. They are derived from minerals. They are either made up of certain non-metals or certain earthy materials. They are made out of reactions, or they are generated from the minerals. They are normally HCl, H2SO4, HNO3. HCl is hydrochloric acid. This is sulfuric acid. HNO3 is nitric acid. Now H2CO3, it is known as carbonic acid. Then phosphoric acid. Then sulfurous acid. These are different examples of mineral acids. They are all derived synthetically, or they are derived from the earth or the minerals. So what is the difference between organic acids and mineral acids? Mostly all organic acids are weak acids. Weak acid means when they come in contact with water, means for example, when acetic acid comes in contact with water or it dissolves in aqueous solution, it will give H plus and CH3 COO minus. So here the amount of H plus ions which is released in aqueous solution is very less. This you can understand, like for example humne 100 ml acetic acid लिया तो उसमें से हो सकता है 10 या 15 हाइड्रोजन, ओनली 10 to 15 हाइड्रोजन आयन जो है वो उसमें से रिलीज हो, बाकी जो है वो एज इट इज मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्म में रहें. क्या रहें? एज इट इज मॉलिक्यूलर फॉर्म में रहे सारे के सारे एच प्लस आयन्स जो है इसमें से टूट करके H प्लस के फॉर्म में रिलीज नहीं होंगे. ओनली फ्यूअर अमाउंट ऑफ H प्लस आयन इज रिलीज्ड बाय दिस एडिशन. सो सारे के सारे H प्लस आयन्स एसिटिक एसिड ने नहीं छोड़े, इसलिए इसको हम वीक एसिड कहते हैं. क्यों वीक एसिड कहते हैं? क्योंकि जितने H प्लस आयन्स थे सारे के सारे H प्लस आयन्स रिलीज नहीं होंगे. इससे बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस भी आते हैं आपके सीबीएसई में और डिफरेंट पैटर्न के एग्जाम में क्वेश्चंस आते हैं दैट द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ वीक एसिड कंसिस्ट ऑफ यू विल बी आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चंस लाइक the weak acid consists of ions, solutions or ions and molecules, only molecules. So what will you say? In organic acid we can see here that only some part of the H plus ions is released. So most of the acetic acid is remains same in the molecular form. So what will be our answer? The solution of weak acid consists of ions as well as and molecules. Now comes strong acid. Strong acid क्या है? For example हम लेते हैं hydrochloric acid. जब water के contact में आएगा then what will happen? It will convert into H plus and Cl minus. So all the H plus ion which was present in hydrochloric acid gives ions. It will be like this, HCl is not present, only ions are present. So what you can say here is in the solution of strong acid only ions are present. Means here strong acid ionizes completely. Sara ka sara jo H hydrogen ion hai wo ions mein convert ho jayega. Means water mein sara ka sara H plus aur Cl break ho jayega aur sare ke sare aapko ions milenge. Koi bhi HCl ka aisa molecule usme present nahi hoga. Ye difference hota hai strong acid एंड वीक एसिड में. अब सारे के सारे जो आपके ऑर्गेनिक एसिड्स होते हैं वो सारे के सारे क्या करते हैं? वीक एसिड होते हैं बिकॉज दे डू नॉट डोनेट ऑल द हाइड्रोजन आयन, ओनली सम ऑफ द आयन्स आर रिलीज्ड एंड अदर रिमेन्स एज अ मॉलिक्यूल फॉर्म. वेयर इज इन मिनरल एसिड्स दे आर टर्म्ड एज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग एसिड बिकॉज all the hydrogen ion present in the molecule converts into H plus ions, means they release all the ions whatever present. If we are taking 100 ml means all the 100 H plus ions which is present in HCl will be released in water and it will be in the form of ions. So solution of a strong acid consists only ions, and solution of weak acid consists of molecules and ions. There is one exception in mineral acid, that H2CO3, this carbonic acid is the only mineral acid. Carbonic acid is the only mineral acid which is a weak acid. Means when it will give the ions, or when it will come in contact with water, it will not give all the H plus ion. It will remain as a molecule, or it will not dissociate all the H plus ion. Only part of H plus will be released. So this is the only example, or this is the exception of mineral acid, which is a weak acid. So if you are asked a confusing question or a tricky question, that H2 solution of H2CO3 will consist of ions and molecules, or only molecules. So you will answer ions and molecules. Now we have already studied that this consists of ions, molecules. One more thing comes, that is basicity. Basicity of acid. Now you must have got confused. ये क्या बोल रही है मैडम? एसिड भी बोल रही है और बेसिसिटी भी बोल रही है एक साथ. बेसिसिटी एंड एसिडिटी ये क्या चीज है? बेसिसिटी ऑफ एसिड मीन्स नंबर ऑफ आयनाइजेबल एच प्लस आयन्स वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ acid contains. Means एक acid का molecule, one molecule of acid, for example HCl, इस molecule में कितने number of ionizable H plus ions present है? हो सकता है hydrogen बहुत सारे present हो, पर H प्लस आयनाइजेबल, जिसको आयनाइज किया जा सके, जिसको H प्लस में कन्वर्ट किया जा सके, वो कितने H प्लस आयन्स हैं? मीन्स जब इनका रिएक्शन होगा तो एक एसिड जो है कितना H प्लस आयन्स देगा. दैट H प्लस आयन्स, दैट नंबर ऑफ आयनाइजेबल H प्लस आयन्स इज नोन एज बेसिसिटी ऑफ एसिड. सो विथ द नंबर ऑफ आयन्स विच इज इट इज गेटिंग जनरेटेड is termed as its basicity. So for example, we take different acids. This has only H plus, one H plus, so it is called as monobasic. One means mono, and number of H plus ions is known as, ionizable ions is known as basicity. So monobasic. HNO3, here you will see the number of H plus ions it is giving is 1, so it is also monobasic. Now another one, H2SO4, that is here it is having 2 H plus ions, so it is called dibasic. Di means 2, basic means its basicity, a number of H plus ions, the number H plus ions is termed as basic here, basicity. Means it will donate. And 2 means di. So here H2SO4 is dibasic. अब आपको ये लग रहा होगा कि मैडम तो जितने हाइड्रोजन है उतने को उसकी बेसिसिटी बता रही है. पर ये एक कंफ्यूजन है, उसको हम अभी क्लियर करेंगे। पहले ये फॉस्फोरिक एसिड को देख लेते हैं, इसमें क्या है, 3H+ है, सो हियर 3H+ डोनेट हो रहा है, इसको हम कहेंगे ट्राई बेसिक। ट्राई बेसिक एसिड, मोनोबेसिक 1H+, डाई बेसिक 2H+, ट्राई बेसिक 3H+। अब मैंने कहा ना कि आपको कंफ्यूजन होगा कि जितने हाइड्रोजन है उतने को ही हम गिन लेते हैं। ट्राई बेसिक एसिड। नाउ अब ये कंफ्यूजन हम दूर करते हैं कि बेसिसिटी का मतलब सिर्फ हाइड्रोजन से नहीं है, इसका मतलब है कितने H+ आयंस डोनेट हो रहे हैं। तो यहां पर हम एग्जांपल लेते हैं एसिटिक एसिड का, विच इज एन ऑर्गेनिक एसिड। एसिटिक एसिड में नंबर ऑफ रिप्लेसेबल आयंस केवल एक है। ये जो है यहां देखेंगे आप, आपको लग रहा है चार हाइड्रोजन है, पर आयनाइजेबल आयंस कितने हैं, केवल एक है, क्योंकि ये टूटता है H+CH3COOH, मतलब ये माइनस में और ये प्लस में, इस तरीके से टूटता है। तो ये क्या हो गया, एक मोनोबेसिक है, मोनोबेसिक एसिड है ये। नाउ दूसरा हम देखते हैं फॉर्मिक एसिड। फॉर्मिक एसिड हियर आल्सो यू आर सीइंग देयर आर टू हाइड्रोजन, बट मैडम इज राइटिंग ओनली वन हाइड्रोजन। Why it is so? Because it will convert into this ion and H+, so it is also monobasic. अब ये ऐसा क्यों है, इसका लेना देना इसके स्ट्रक्चर से है। स्ट्रक्चर से कैसे लेने देना है इसको आप समझेंगे। जो फॉर्मिक एसिड होता है उसका फॉर्मूला इस तरीके का होता है, ठीक है। ये जो फॉर्मिक एसिड है इसका स्ट्रक्चरल फॉर्मूला ये होता है। अब इसमें केवल वही हाइड्रोजन टूटकर निकलेगा जो ऑक्सीजन से अटैच हो, मींस जब आयनाइजेशन होगा H+ में टूटेगा तो ओनली दैट हाइड्रोजन विल बी टेकन आउट विच इज अटैच्ड टू ऑक्सीजन। सो हियर इट इज अटैच्ड टू कार्बन, सो इट विल नॉट डिसोसिएट, सो इट विल डिसोसिएट। There is a deep chemistry behind it, so that we will discuss in our class. So only that oxygen which is attached to hydrogen will convert into H+ ion. So here it is only one. So in case of formic acid, we can say it is a monobasic acid. Other hydrogen is not getting detached. Same way, in case of acetic acid, we will see that only one hydrogen is attached with oxygen and all other three are attached with the carbon. So only one hydrogen will break and give H+ ion. That's why, due to its structure, acetic acid is also a monobasic acid. Now in case of phosphoric acid, you are seeing here that only three I have written. In other acid also there will be, in H3PO3 phosphorus acid, you will see there is number of hydrogen more, but the basicity of hydrogen is phosphoric acid is less. So it depends on structure only. See here, in case of phosphoric acid we will see the hydrogen which is attached to oxygen will give H+ ion. So three hydrogens are attached with oxygen, so there is basicity is 3 in case of phosphoric acid. One more acid is there, H3PO3. Here you will see that basicity is lesser. So you will see here that in case of this PO OH OH H, so only two hydrogen are attached with oxygen, so its basicity is only 2. 2H plus ions is released. Other hydrogen is attached with phosphorus only. So the basicity of phosphorus acid as 3PO3 is 2H plus. So it is dibasic in nature. So this is all about basicity of acid. So in this class we have studied what is acid, what is base, and in detail we have studied what are organic acid, what are mineral acids. Also we have discussed the difference between strong acid and weak acid. And in the last we have studied about basicity of acid. Basicity of acid means number of ionizable H plus ions present in one molecule of acid. Means in one molecule of acid, how many number of ionizable ions are present. And basicity is dependent on the structure of a molecule. So this is all about acid. In the next class, we will study about preparation of acid or bases. Thank you.